guys, maybe I have to show you how to do your own jazzy painting at home. The first thing you have to do is to make your own screen. Then cut your numbers. I prefer you using a glossy paper, and let's say something like this. This is the number 2. You cut it. You can also make it as a reusable one. After using it, you can dry it under the sun. When it is dry, you can keep it for your next jazzes that you want to print. This is the sample of the screen that we have made. We also something like this. You can make it from scratch, make it on all the woods, carve it, and then put this screen on it. In case you want to have something like this and you want to do it for yourself, you can send us an email asmultiply@gmail.com, or still you can call us at 301-6053, or visit our Facebook page and drop us a message in there. So after doing all this and making your screen, cutting your numbers, you can see this is a football club called Sidamuma United FC. We have cut a sticker and put it on top because this is the main name that is going to be on all the jerseys. It's a unique one. So after putting a sticker here, that is going to remain for all the numbers. So now we are changing the numbers as we go, from number 1, 2, 3, and so on. So don't use a Saritex ink, bitch. It's not perfect for your jazzy printing. It might fade away. Instead, you can use a plastic soil ink, which is very perfect for printing jazzes. And then after that, you can hold your screen. Please hold this for me. And now you can lay your vest down, but make sure the ground you are using is clean from all ink debts. Try to clean it up. Remember, you don't need to mirror when you are cutting or printing your numbers. You don't need to mirror them, because if you mirror them, once you put them on the screen, they are going to print invertedly. And make sure you don't forget, the area that you want to print is the only area that you have to leave on the screen. All the other area you have to put tapes on it, so that the screen, the ink will not stain the side that you don't want to be want to print on the jersey or on the side that you want to print. The next step you have to do now is to place your screen on the middle of the T-shirt, so that you can perfectly have the center. I'm used to doing it, so you might need to use a ruler to be able to do it perfectly. Then you have somebody to hold the screen for you. You also have clippers that you can use, like rulers that you can use to print. If you have the money to buy it, you can buy it. We are not in the market for that, because we don't need it. So we use this manual printing, and then use your scraper to scrape the ink on top of the. Make sure you have enough ink when you are pressing, when you are printing. Make sure you exercise some pressure on top of the screen, so that your number can come out very clean and perfect. After that, place your scraper down, and then somebody will hold the t-shirt up, and then you pull it out. You have a perfect number 10 on your jersey that everybody will see and love. Now you have to dry it under the sun, and then later use your heating machine if you have one, and then press it on top of the heating machine.